Welcome to Morning Manna with Pastor Steve Myrie. Today's topic, be the change. And there were four leprous men at the entering of the gate. And they said one to another, why sit we here until we die? If we say we will enter into the city, then the famine is in the city, and we shall die there. And if we sit here, we will die also. Now therefore, come, and let us fall unto the host of the Syrians. If they save us alive, we shall live. And if they kill us, we shall die. 2 Kings 7, 3 through 4. The timid, soft steps of the four leprous men cautiously walk on the path to the Syrian camp was amplified and magnified by God into a roar of chariot wheels rumbling, swords clanging, horses panting, soldiers shouting, and trumpets blasting. This roar melted the Syrian soldiers' hearts with a great fear of a devastating defeat. The noise of the confusion went through the camp like a windswept fire. The church may seem like a ragtag group of weakened soldiers with low budgets, unpaid leaders, with highly criticized efforts, with a task that seems unattainable, unimaginable, and unfathomable. But God can amplify our voice, magnify our work, glorify our endeavors. He can also rectify our failures, mystify our enemies, and gratify our labor. Many are waiting for God to move, but God is saying, don't just sit there, do something. Problems are always the doorway to the next level of growth. That's why God allows us to experience them. David and Goliath, the first words ever spoken by David in the Bible, are, what shall be done to the man that killeth the Philistine and taketh away the reproach from Israel? Who is this uncircumcised Philistine that he should defy the armies of the living God? David shows up discussing God. We have yet to see another soldier, his brothers, the king, mention God. Can I tell you that you may be the only one in this world who's talking about God? No one else was discussing God. David discusses no one else but God. David sees what others don't see and refuses to see what others do. Everyone else for 40 days has majored on Goliath. David majored on God. I can see David's brother's embarrassment, Saul's sigh, Goliath as he throws back his head in laughter, just enough to shift his helmet and expose a square inch of his forehead's flesh. David spotted the target and seized the opportunity. How long has it been since you ran towards your challenges? How long has it been since you became the solution and not the problem? Will Rogers said, if you're on the right track, you'll get run over if you just sit there. Not everything that is faced can be changed, but nothing can be changed until it's faced. It's time to stand up and be the change. The thought of the day, problems are always the doorway to the next level of growth. That's why God allows us to experience them. God bless you today, in Jesus' name.
Please remember to like and subscribe to my page on YouTube. Your support is much appreciated.
Hey, Waymaker, miracle walker, promise keeper, light in the darkness.